personal autonomous robots like the Neo Home robot, the Tesla Optimus, the Figure 03 robot. They promised this at-home or at-office affordable autonomy robots that everybody is going to want and are going to be available all over the place at an affordable price. But guys, there is something that they are hiding. In today's video, we're going to talk about where autonomous robots are today, where they're going, and where humans actually fall in to the workplace in this new world. And why this is so important, guys, is because Neo Home Robot was premiered last week, and you can actually order one now. You can put down a $200 deposit right now to buy one of these home robots. You could go right to their website and order one right now. In fact, they had a very, very exciting video about this home robot, and let's actually check that out. Let's check out this robot right now and see what we are dealing with here. Look at this. This robot walking around, doing chores, dancing. Look how excited they are. We come home and our robot has been doing all this work for us. It follows me around. It helps me carry boxes. It's taking out the trash. It's doing the laundry. It's walking up and down stairs. Look at it performing all this. It even dances for me. How amazing. It's your little buddy. And I gotta say, the idea of living in the world where the Jetsons and Rosie is performing all these tasks is really appealing. But guys, it's not real. It's not real. When you look at the actions that this robot is doing, these are all net opt-in. This is not an autonomous robot. Do not be fooled. Don't think that you can go and just buy this robot. It is not there yet. You see it dusting. You see it moving around. This robot is being remote controlled by a human being off-site. Okay? And listen, this promise that it's going to provide assistance with everyday tasks, automate household chores, free time for priorities. By the way, you can pre-order one of these. You can have one for $500 a month. But the big question is, can they deliver? Can they deliver? There was this idea, there's this idea that if you can envision it and you can see it, it can manifest, it can be there. And maybe this will happen. In fact, in here you can see that these are, things that possibly could happen. But we're not there yet. The majority of the tasks that are being shown are net opt-in. And down here, you can actually see what's autonomous and what's net opt. And this is actually brand new because they got a lot of shade. Listen, it's going to come up. It'll grab the dish. It'll walk away. I think this is pretty exciting. But the reason I want to show this to you guys is, by the way, this is expert mode. These are all tasks that are going to be done by the robot that is net opt-in. It's going to clean the bathroom. These are things that are... Neo works autonomously by default for any chore it doesn't know. You can schedule one expert to guide it. And right now, this is the majority of what's happening. So will they be able to pull this off in the future? We don't know. I mean, the reality is this is the worst this technology is ever going to be. It's only going to get better. But here's why I bring this up, guys, because there is a belief, and I've seen it in the comments. By the way, if you're new here, I'm bringing you a fresh video 6 days a week, Monday through Saturday. And most of the time I'm walking, but I thought for these robot videos, I want to show them. You have to see them. You have to see them. And so that's why I'm sharing the video this way. But guys, there is this belief, and I've seen this comment come up quite a bit, that there's no place for me in this new world, that the robots are going to be able to do everything. There's no value that I can bring. AI is going to learn faster than me. Robots are going to work more effectively than me. Why even try? Guys, your families your families need you, man. This technology is really exciting. It is super cool. Super, super cool. But don't get it twisted. You have infinite value. And if your belief is I'm going to lay up and die, that there's nothing I can do to compete. Guys, that's the wrong mentality. I mean, listen, these are going to displace jobs, millions of jobs, tens of millions of jobs, hundreds of millions of jobs are going to be displaced. But there's still going to be a need for human beings. Guys, and you might disagree with me, and you're welcome to put it in the comments below. But this, I your family needs you, guys. Your kids need you. Your wife needs you. Your church needs you. Your community needs you. You can't just lay up and die. There are going to be opportunities. There are things that robots can't do. And I'm just going to give you a quick story here before I keep going into it. There are so many people, I wrote about this in my newsletter this week. There are so many people right now that are that think that they're working smart, not hard, but they're actually working lazy. You understand what I'm saying here? You've seen it out there before. You go to someone's Facebook page and they've just copy and pasted some garbage from ChatGPT and they're selling it off like it's their own idea. In fact, I saw someone the other day give a movie review that was copy and pasted from ChatGPT. Guys, do we understand how insane that is? That you are so lazy that you are not even giving your own opinions on ideas. You're just copy and pasting stuff from ChatGPT. And I ran into this this week. I asked a team member to perform a task for me. And what this guy did was he put in a 2-second prompt, a lazy ass prompt, guys. I'm sorry. The prompt was lazy. If you're watching this, I know it was a lazy prompt because I use ChatGPT every day. And I know that prompt was lazy. Gets the prompt back, copy and paste it, sends it to me and said, "Mark, job's done." I was pissed because the work that it gave me was crap. It was just riddled with mistakes. It had all these weird emojis. There was no thought in it. And guys, that is what the majority of people are doing right now. I know I'm getting a little bit off topic. We're here to talk about robots. But the point I'm trying to make is that you're going to have value. You're going to have value. So anyway, this Neo Home robot, it went super viral. Everyone's thinking the future is here. The future is now. Robots are going to be performing all these tasks for me. But it's not there yet, guys. This is remote opt-in. Now, it's going to get better. Are they going to be able to hit their deadline of delivering these home robots that are autonomous by early next year? I don't know. We'll see. But we saw this at a Tesla showing last year, Tesla Optimus bots being net opt-in. We're at a point now, guys, where a lot of the videos that we're seeing from robots are very, 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 very impressive. But the question here is, is this real? Is this real or is this net opt-in? Here's Elon dancing with a Tesla Optimus robot to celebrate his big payday. But is this a Tesla robot actually dancing? Or is this a human net opting in? By the way, even if it's a human net opting in, I still think it's pretty freaking impressive. But don't sell me autonomous robots when it's just someone dancing. When it's someone behind the scenes dancing. By the way, if you haven't followed me on X now, you definitely should. Mark Savant Media on X. Follow me there. But is this real? I would bet you. I don't know. And that's you know, we're living in this world now where when you see something, you have to second guess it. You can't just take it as scripture. Now, again, that said, this technology is pretty freaking amazing. Look what this robot hand is capable of. Look at the dexterity. The human hand is very, very complex, guys. Look at how impressive. This is very, 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 very impressive. I'm not saying this to discount how impressive it is. What I am saying is that before you go out and say that there's no place for you, that the robots are going to do everything, understand that we don't know. You don't know that for sure. You can't afford to take that perspective. Now, I do want to show you something here that I posted on X. I think it was yesterday or earlier today. This is a message from Elon Musk at the latest. And I want to kind of run through this because I think this is really interesting.
With no one
here
minding them. They're just sitting. And round out our engineering headquarters in Palo Alto, the robots are just walking around the office 24/7 with no one minding them. They're just, and then they go charge themselves. And
So what is he saying? He's saying that they have robots now. That we get it. We know that robots can do that. Okay. What we're not ready for is robots doing the laundry, doing the dishes, taking out the dog, working in the home office, or working at it. You know, like your robot butler is not here yet. You could have a butler. You could have a butler controlling a robot in your home, but at that point, why not just hire a butler, right? But what he is saying is that already in their offices in Palo Alto, they have these robots walking around, charging themselves, mind you. And by the way, there is this thought that, you know, well, the robot, humans have to recharge, so do robots. Yeah, that's true. But a robot can simply take out one battery and put a new battery in. They don't need to be, there can be zero downtime. So if you're putting robots in warehouses, by the way, I recorded an entire video about what Amazon is doing with robots in warehouses. You have to see it right now. They already have 1 million robots in their warehouses. They plan on bringing on 600,000 more. So there's no stopping that. The robots are here. The humanoid robots. Anyway, let's continue. Let's let Elon continue, because I got to say, I know people don't like Elon, and you know, he might be the Antichrist. I don't know. I don't know what Elon's mind is, but what I do know is that when Elon puts his mind to something, he gets it done. He gets it done. Like the stuff that he's had to do with Tesla. I mean, he caught a freaking spaceship, guys. He caught a rocket out of space at SpaceX. That is just mind blowing. To me, that is possible. Anyway, let's let him continue.
So the scale of Optimus, like I said, that's really going to be something else. I think it's going to be the biggest product of all time by far. Yeah. So, like bigger than cell phones, bigger than anything. I guess a way to think about it is that every human on Earth is going to want to have their own personal R2-D2 C-3PO.
By the way, I know a lot of people say, I don't trust it. I don't like it. I don't want a robot in my house. I will 1,000% want a personal robot assistant. By the way, put in the comments below. You don't want a robot assistant? Put in the comments below. That's cool. I want a robot assistant. I'm sorry. This sounds awesome to me.
So who wouldn't? But actually, Optimus will be even better than that. You know, like, you know, R2-D2, it's kind of beep at you, and it's kind of hard to figure out what he's talking about. You know, you need C-3PO to translate. But Optimus is going to be, everyone's going to want one. I think in terms of industry providing products and services, I think it's probably, 3 to 5 robots in industry for every, you know, one that's a personal robot. I think that.
So every human on Earth is going to want a personal robot. And in industry, there's going to be about 3 to 5 per person. By the way, just a quick note, the Neo Home robot, the Tesla Optimus, the Figure 03, they all are about 5'6". They're 5'6". So they're kind of like at that. I don't know if that's because that's like the average human height or because it's a little bit less scary. Could you imagine if these robots were 7'2"? They would be terrifying. All right, let's let Elon continue because he's about to get to a really important point.
It could be tens of billions of, I think there could be tens of billions of.
Let's repeat that one time.
Optimus robots. I think there could be tens of billions of Optimus robots out there. Now, obviously, it's very important we pay close attention to safety here.
Tens of billions of Optimus robots. Right now, there's what, 8 billion humans on Earth? Tens of billions of Optimus robots. That's just in Tesla. That's just Optimus. He's not even talking about these other companies like Neo and Figure. Tens of billions. That when I heard him say this, I'm still kind of wrapping my head around that. Tens of billions of humanoid robots walking around the world. Can you see any potential threats there?
Because we do want the Star Wars movie, not the Jim Cameron movie.
That's the Terminator.
I love Jim Cameron's movies, but you know, you know what I mean.
He doesn't even want to speak it into existence because of how scary it is. And by the way, Elon in the past has said that there's a 20% chance that AI destroys humanity, but it's worth it. There, guys, the risks with AI and robotics are very real. They are very, very real. Very real.
So, Yeah.
And by the way, I talked about this the other day. This is why it's really important that the right people control the robots. Like, you don't want, there are some countries that might have bad ideas. Like, the future of warfare, I can't even wrap my head around how many drones and humanoid robots and dog robots are going to be running around. There's going to be 10-foot tall Goliath tank robots. It's, I'm going to take my glasses off here for a second because I don't want to get too dystopian on you guys. I'm an optimistic kind of guy. And I think that Tesla Optimus, that Neo Home Robot, the Figaro 3 robots are going to be really cool. But to sit here and say that there's no threats would be naive. It would be naive. And I'm going to kind of close it out here, guys. And say, by the way, thanks for like, subscribing. Thanks for commenting below. The last time I covered robots, I think we had 800 comments. It was insane. But, you know, here's the point, guys. A, robots are happening. You're not going to stop robots. You're not going to be able to vote for robots not to happen. Robots are going to happen, okay? Let's be real. Robots are happening, okay? A. B, you're going to need to compete with robots because when you go to find new clients, when you go to find a new job, you're going to have to show, I am actually valuable here. I am valuable, and while robots are helpful, I like robots to support me. I'm going to be able to bring your business to the next level. I'm going to be able to provide value here, okay? And three, don't think that you're not going to be able to compete. There is a mentality here. So there's actually two mentalities, but there is a mentality out here that is pervasive that says the robots can be better at everything. AI is going to be smarter than me at everything. It's going to learn faster. Why even try? Guys, I'm going to take my glasses off here for a second, guys. You are a human being creating the image of God. You have infinite value. This is a robot. It is metal. You are a human being. Never, never, never discount how valuable you are. And I don't want to make this a big motivational speech, but I just want you to understand your value in the world, all right? You are valuable. You will have value, but the problems that you're solving today are not going to be the problems that you're going to be solving in the future. The world is changing very quickly. That is why I want to highlight this video. This is what I want to do on the channel, to say, hey, the world's changing. You need to adapt to it. And there's lots of things that you can do to adapt. And I talk about them often. You're going to need to learn. You're going to need to evolve. You're going to need to rely on relationships. And let me close it down. Let me just close it down here because I'm going a little bit long. Guys, next time you get in your car, before you turn on the radio, before you turn on a podcast, pop open your phone and call someone you respect you haven't spoken to in a while. See what they're up to. Are they worried about this? How are they looking at AI? What are the opportunities? The relationships are going to matter more than just about anything else. In fact, yesterday I covered Indeed. Check out yesterday's video. We covered how Indeed is going through another round of firings and layoffs. Why? Because AI is changing the job market. And quite frankly, these job searching platforms are completely flooded with AI slop. You're 4 times more likely to get hired, to find a new client if you get a referral. So rely on your relationships, guys. That's my challenge for you. Put it in the comments below if you've done the challenge. I've been talking about this for a few days here. But next time you get in the car, call somebody you haven't spoken to in a while. Talk to them and just figure out what they're up to. That relationship is going to matter. All right, boys, I'm going to go ahead and close it down here. Go out and make it a great day. While you're watching this, I am going to be on a river, camping, hanging out with my boys and my daughter. It is going to be a great day. I hope you're having a great day as well. All right, boys, see ya. Peace.